Well, I didn't tell you because it didn't matter. Cosmic Corn stays on their side of town, we stay on ours.
But it wasn't always that way.
Hey, Greco, backup hot sauces?
Right above the register beds.
Oh, I see them.
What about your truck?
Oh, I got a staff working it. It's cool. We look out for each other.
Some more than others. Can't afford to shut down, not even for a day. Not in this business.
Which brings us back to your feud.
How did it start?
I was headline cook at Dasher's in Georgetown for years, and then COVID shut us down. And suddenly out of a job, I get this corn idea. And since nobody else was doing it, I sunk my life savings and every credit card I had to make it happen. I struggled at first, but then, you know, Marty came to help, and pretty soon business was booming. You know, until...
Until Cosmic Corn.
Until another cook from Dasher's, a now former buddy of mine, opened up his own truck, yeah.
Your buddy stole your idea?
Stole my idea, my recipe. Even the K's we use in our name.
Oh, that's straight up slimy.
Well, Marty and I thought so too, until the restraining orders forced us to do business miles apart. So he's out of sight, out of mind ever since, at least until now.
It's McGee.
Hey, McGee, you're on speaker.
Hey, one of these blogs just gave me a location for Cosmic Corn, an industrial park on 10th and Ardale.
We're a few blocks away from there.
Hey, are you Pete Cannizzaro?
Yeah, just take a number and I'll be right with you.
I don't like him already.
You don't like what he did.
And you do? I say we drag him out by his feet for breaking his restraining order.
I say there are other ways to get answers. Plus, you might even get some great corn out of it. Just follow my lead.
Mr. Cannizzaro, we're not here to eat, actually. I'm writing an article for a food truck aficionado, and I'd love to feature what we're told is the best corn in town.
In the universe. But, as you can see, I'm swamped over here.
Well, maybe we could help.
What? What?
Yeah, my husband Nick and I, we could get behind the scenes, make it a real hands-on story. We've both been vaccinated.
You have any experience?
No.
Tons, Nick.
Well, be honest, Ellie, you know, we don't have tons of experience, but, I mean, how hard can it be? It's just corn.
Oh, and you think it's easy? Okay, hot shots. Climb aboard and, do exactly what I tell you. I need 3 Italian, 2 Mexican, 2 limes and an orange.
2 limes and an orange.
3 Italian, 2 Mexican.
Cancel one of the Italians, make it a Taiwanese.
Okay, which ones are Taiwanese again?
It's one with a green label.
Okay.
And after that, I need 2 honey butter and 4 Mexican.
Thank you.
So, how did you get the idea to serve corn on the cob?
I don't know. Most everybody loves corn, and nobody else was doing it.
Nobody else?
Well, you know, there's nothing new under the sun, right?
Right, so these are all in killer recipe.
Yeah, it's my own twist on it, yeah. Mm-hmm. These are all limes.
Oh,
I need a...
one orange. Coming right up.
Hey, so I saw this thing online about some other corn guys, like some kind of feud or something.
Oh, it was just a big misunderstanding. I have some regrets about that. Okay, whoa, oh, careful, Mr. How Hard Can Corn Be?
Here.
Can't have a mess in here.
Nick, I'll help you. So, just a big misunderstanding, huh?
Yeah, I don't like talking about it. I haven't even seen those guys since the restraining orders.
Are you sure about that?
Sure about what?
You ever seen the Killer Corn guys or Marty Delfino? What does that look like to you?
Well, that looks like blood.
It's probably just hot sauce.
Nope. No, it's definitely not hot sauce.
Okay, hold on now. I can explain.
We're gonna have to.